Hello and welcome. My name is Schuyler Smith. I do technical sales and support here at Apogee Instruments. And we're here talking about our frequently asked questions and put it into a video. We're going to talk about meter operations for M models from Apogee Instruments. So today's video is going to include information for the following: the MQ 100, 200, 300, and 500 series, the MU200, the MP100 and 200, the MI200 and MO200. And what we're going to go over is what it looks like in sample mode, how to move it from sample mode to log mode, and in log mode, all the information that we are collecting, and then the AC100 software, including connection, and just a quick analysis using that. So in sample mode, okay, that's just a picture of the MQ200 over there. But in sample mode, we press the sample button to record up to 99 manual measurements. So in a greenhouse type application, you could push the sample button if you were in a certain location and you wanted to sample there. However, it does not record any timestamp when you hit sample. So you would probably want a notepad next to you to say sample one taken at certain time in certain location if you were doing that type of application. And then log mode. Now I'm going to do a demo of how to do all this in log mode. I just wanted to put it up here because this is a video in case you wanted to pause it and refer back to this later. So let's go ahead and do our hands-on demo. Just give me a second to pull it up here. All right, so here we go. We have our MQ500 for demo right now. We'll go ahead and turn it on. And we'll just go ahead. What we're looking at here is we see SMPL right here. It means we're in sample mode. The 8 in this example with our MQ500 is showing us there's 8 micromoles per meter squared per second coming in from these lights. And then the 17 up here in the corner is showing us that there are currently 17 samples saved on here. Okay. If we want to review any of those samples, we just push the down button. And then it goes through, and we can see that number up top changing as we go through all the various samples saved on here. All right, if we want to get out of scroll, we just hit the sample button, and then we're back to the menu. To get to log mode, we hit the mode button, and then we see sample blinking. We push down, we push mode again, and then mode again. Now what it's telling us is it's in log mode. Again, our light reading's the same. And it's telling us that there are currently 99 saved 30-minute averages. So it only records those 30-minute averages, and there are already 99 on here. So for all the new ones that it's logging, it is erasing the oldest one on here. If we want to scroll through those 30-minute averages, we just push down, and it will allow us to see each one of those averages. And so in this example, where it was placed in a break room and recording the light from the sun in the break room, as we continue to scroll through, we'll see it at zero for night and then come back and show us the low light of yesterday afternoon. So that is log mode. If we want to get out of scrolling, we hit sample, and then we can see that we're back on log mode on those 99. Now it averages those, it takes a reading every 30 seconds, then averages those 30 second readings into 30 minute averages and records those. Then, every 48 of those 30-minute averages, it records as a day, and then it will save those as daily light integrals, or daily totals. So for each one of the M models, it will save a daily total that you can access through the software. So let's go back and look at that. Talked about log mode. The one point I do want to make here again is 99 sample measurements. We talked about how you can scroll through those. 99 log measurements. Talked about how you can scroll through those. But to get the 99 daily totals, you do need the AC100 software with the AC100 cord. The reason you need the AC100 cord is because the meter outputs using UART protocol. and it requires that AC100 to convert it from UART to USB. So a regular USB cord will not allow you to get the data off of this onto your computer. So the data, the software comes on the USB flash drive, but if for whatever reason you've lost the software or you've switched computers, I can show you where you can get that off the internet. I'm going to show that in the demo here in a second. And then we'll do a demo on connecting to the AC100. So here we will. We'll go ahead and pull up the website. So here we are at the home site, apogeeinstruments.com. In order to get to the software, let's click over here on the support tab. All right, and I'm going to put a plug in. There is fantastic information on the support tab, so feel free to refer here if you have any questions about anything. So from the support tab, we're going to come to scroll down here to software downloads, and then we're going to scroll through until we see handheld meter data collection software. It's a picture of the MQ500, but remember, this is for any of our M models. And we'll click right here on the Apogee AMS for PC. And when we click on that, we can see it start to download down here. This is the common way that Windows does downloads for all the new versions. Once it's completely downloaded as a .exe file, we can click on it, and then it will bring up the install shield configuring Windows installer. So pretty standard operation. We're just going to cancel out of this for this example. So yes, I want it for mine. But of course, if you need it, go ahead and download it. Follow those steps. So once we are here, we can see our Apogee AMS up here on our desktop. So here we are, a blank screen. Let's go ahead and connect using our AC100 cable. We'll go ahead and slide that right in and connect. And nothing happens, which is fine. We have to actually connect, and we do that by hitting open port. If I hit open port right now, it says connection failed. Why is that? I need to just go right here and go to the correct COM. Well, how do I know which COM port is correct? Well, that's easy. I'll show you. So we go right here, and on Windows 10, it's very easy. We need to find the device manager. So the easiest way to find that on Windows 10 is to click here and type device. And then device manager comes up right there. And what we're looking for is COM port, which is right here. And then we want USB serial port. This is what we're looking for. We just need to know what the USB serial port was. We see it says COM 5. We can close out of that. So now we know COM 5. We hit the arrow right here, and we see COM 1, COM 5. Now let's say that the COM we just saw on your device manager doesn't appear in your dropdown. Easy fix. Just go right there, pick whatever COM does show up, put the cursor in there, erase it, and put the COM you do want. So I want COM 5, so I put COM 5, then I hit open port. Now it says connected. Now that I'm connected, these buttons are now active. I can see my sample data. So it's showing us those 17 saved sample datas. I click on 30-minute averages. We'll take a second or two to load all of those. And then I'm seeing those 99 30-minute averages, and then daily totals. So this is what we're getting in our example with the MQ500. This is all of our saved daily light integrals. Looks like there's about just under 60 of them on here, and showing us what our, again, our moles per day would be in this example. So now let's say we want to analyze the data. Okay. So first thing is we can go up here to File, and we can go to Save As, and this will save it as a CSV file. So Save As Type, CSV. So right here is one that we saved earlier, pretty self-explanatory. But let's just say we want to do a quick data analysis with what we have here. So let's just copy this, Control C, and let's just pull up a blank Excel spreadsheet, and we'll paste it in there. And then we can see it's that CSV format, so we do need to delimit it. So let's just click down here on the data, click up here on data, click text to columns, need to delimit it. And then we're next, we're going to do it by comma, hit next, finish. All right, so now we have all that text to columns. So let's just go ahead and highlight that row. I click over here on this nifty little tool in Excel and go to charts. Go to line. So our quick data analysis is showing us that when we took it off, we could see the sun was just coming out. We were getting a lot more micromoles per meter squared per second today than we have been the last 2 days when it's been very rainy. To conclude, thank you very much for watching our video on the basic operations of our M models here at Apogee Instruments. Feel free to send us any inquiries or questions to techsupport@apogeeinstruments.com. Thank you.